Hey guys, Alan Hain here, the lawn care nut with another lawn tip. Now today we're going to talk about lawn aeration or core aeration. Now, I'm going to break this video down into three main parts. So I'll try to list below where those parts start and end so you can kind of skip to the one that means the most to you. Of course, I'd hope that all of you watch the entire video. So in the first part of the video, we're just going to talk about core aeration and what it does, what the benefits are to the lawn. It is the single most important thing you can do to a lawn each year. In the second part of the video, I'm going to actually show you how to use a core aerator, because even though it looks easy, it's not. The machine is going to beat the living crap out of you. And then in the third part, I'm going to show you what happens when you don't follow the safety tips and you don't know how to use an aerator and you don't practice ahead of time. I'm going to show you one thing that can happen that's not cool. So the first thing to understand about core aeration is that you want to make sure you get an actual core aerator. This is a machine that's got hollow tines that roll across the lawn and basically remove cores of soil that are a couple inches long and about the diameter of a dime. By doing this, you're actually loosening up the soil, because as summertime goes and things get heated up, the lawn can get compacted. It's almost like trying to grow grass on cement. It's just not going to work. And a compacted lawn is one that's not conducive to good growth. By aerating, you're removing cores of soil and you're allowing grass roots to basically relax. And relaxing like that allows the grass roots to grow deeper and thicker. In fact, when I had a bunch of sales reps at the lawn care company years ago, I used to make them repeat it every time. Deeper and thicker, deeper and thicker. But that's really the case. We want the lawn to get deeper and thicker roots. Obviously, deeper, thicker roots create a thicker top. You can core aerate basically any time of the year that you can pull a plug, which is going to be spring and fall, typically not in the summer. So when you rent the aerator, they're all just a little bit different, okay, but typically you're going to have an on and off switch like you see here and a choke. So make sure you set the choke back, pull one time, then move the choke forward, pull again, and your aerator should start up just like you see here. This is my junior lawn care nut assistant, Levi Arvin.
Go ahead.
So there are two levers that you're going to use that are going to help operate the machine. The first one is the one you see down below, and what that does is it engages the tines, because it lifts them up and down as you see here. If the tines aren't engaged, they're not going to be able to pull a plug. So before you take off, you engage the tines, and then you have your drive lever. What that does is it basically makes the machine self-propel. It's on a chain, and it turns those tines so the machine will go, because it weighs too much for you to push on your own. The key here is to realize that when you hit the end of a run, you gotta let off the drive lever and then pull the tines up so you can turn the machine. I do not recommend that you try to drive and turn the machine. It's very difficult to do. You can't make tight turns, and if you do, you're gonna rip pieces of the lawn up. So go down, finish your run on an end, so make a straight line, and at the end of the run, disengage the drive, pull the tines up, turn the machine manually around, engage the tines again, engage the drive again, and go forward, back and forth, and back and forth. That's the safest way to do it. The other thing is, since you've gone ahead and rented the aerator, go ahead and do a double pass. Go twice. Go up and back one way, and then go up and back the other way. The more holes you poke, the better. And then finally, you always should wear safety equipment. I recommend steel-toed boots, long pants, and definitely eye protection when you're using this. However, my good buddy here, Chef Joe Arvin, is a chef. He's not a lawn care guy, but when I had the big boy machine out on his lawn, he had to try it. He had to just jump in. And there he is with his flip-flops and shorts on, but he didn't listen to my briefing on how the machine works, and look what happened. Yep, right up on the driveway, and this is what'll happen. This is a big machine, and it will jack up your driveway quickly. So again, practice in an open area. Don't just jump out there and start using the machine. Make sure you practice in an open area where there's no problems, no issues, nothing you're gonna run into. You can rent an aerator for about $20 an hour, usually a 4-hour minimum, so it's a good idea to go in with your neighbors. You guys share the expense and share the work. And of course, share a beer when you're done. I'm Alan Hain, the Lawn Care Nut. I hope this helped you. I will see you in the lawn.